In the meantime, AFP Chief General Joselina Sereno and Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Task Force Chief Panfilo Lacson are one in saying that there will be no let-up in the campaign against kidnapping. Nazareno stressed that the military will still go after the abductors of Benedetti. World leaders are expressing relief that an armed conflict in Iraq has been avoided, at least for now. On Sunday, the United Nations Security Council accepted Baghdad's offer to resume cooperation with arms inspectors. Iraq stopped cooperating late last month and demanded that UN sanctions be lifted. Iraqi newspapers are hailing the agreement as a victory for President Saddam Hussein. The US and Britain had already launched and then aborted the attack order on Saturday when Iraq issued its 11-hour reversal. And still they say the threat is hanging over Iraq's head as the next crisis will bring down immediate strikes without warning. In the Philippines, the Labor Department is calling on Filipino overseas workers, FOWs, in the Middle East to be on the ready for an immediate mass evacuation on the event that hostilities erupt in that place of the world. The Labor Department issued a call as it prepares an elaborate continued contingency plan to evacuate Filipinos in the Gulf region once the U.S. decides to launch an airstrike on Baghdad. Tension on the area is still high after U.S. President Bill Clinton rejected an offer from Iraq which he claimed as inadequate. Here's Theodore Boborol for the latest in entertainment, sports, and lifestyle.
Thanks, Juvie. In showbiz, it was the girls' night out at the 1998 MTV Europe Music Awards. Madonna and the Spice Girls were the big winners during the awards show held last Friday at the Fila Forum Stadium in the fashion capital Milan, Italy. Madonna picked up the Best Female Award and Best New Album for her latest effort, Ray of Light. The Spice Girls, on the other hand, received the Best Group and Best Pop Awards. The Spice Girls were represented by Baby Spice and Sporty Spice. The other remaining Spices, Posh and Scary, had to beg off as they are in fantasy painting. The all-female All Saints, nominated in multiple categories, went home with the Breakthrough Artist Award. The awards, which for the first time included four regional honors, were voted on by MTV viewers. Model Jenny McCarthy hosted the affair. In sports, unseeded Steffi Graf, already recovering from wrist surgery, overcame a sore leg to upset second seed and defending champion Martina Hingis and move on to the semifinals of the Advanta Championships. Graf defeated Hingis 6-2, 4-6, 6-love after having to leave the court momentarily for medical treatment on a pulled leg muscle. When she returned, Graf quickly retook command, allowing Hingis only 8 points in the final 5 games. The loss hurt Hingis' chances to overtake American Lindsay Davenport to regain the top rank. On tonight's lifestyle, it seems that young Asians still look to the West for their identity. A study conducted by AC Nielsen for TNT Warner and Cartoon Network Asia Pacific surveyed 6,000 young people aged 7 to 18 in 12 Asian countries, including Australia. This survey on new generations reveals not only what young Asians like to eat or drink, but it also delves into their psyche. It asks questions with wide and varied topics from entertainment to issues. Majority of those surveyed in all the countries said that their favorite drink is Coca-Cola and that the country that they most want to visit is the USA. It is not surprising that basketball is the Philippines' favorite sport. However, the most admired sports personality is not NBA superstar Michael Jordan, but PBA's Vince the Prince Hizon. The Filipino youth also chose local fast food chain Jollibee over McDonald's or KFC. And that was the lighter side of the news. I'm Theodore Boborol.
That was today's edition of Journal, November 17, 1998.
Join us once again as we bring you the latest events making headlines here and around the world.
This has been Rosa Castillo.
And I'm Juvie Quanio.
Thank you.